So today is 4th of April and we are already progressing on our project. Our project title is Smart Cardio Consultant. So it's basically a device in which the ECG recording of a human body will be taken and then this signals will be processed, first uploaded in the cloud and then processed by our machine learning to give a risk factor which will determine whether the patient is at risk or like he is safe from any kind of dangers. So this we are trying to implement especially in the rural areas where there are no such services available. Like in cities we get ECGs and these things easily, but in rural areas we don't have an ECG setup completely. So our device can substitute an ECG machine as well as a doctor, because when there is no doctor it can show that okay, this person is having a heart attack or this person is not having a heart attack. It has the intelligence to show that part also. So even if the doctor is not there, this machine can help. So if even like if there is a heart attack, it will also show that immediately you should do this, or if the ECG report will go to the actual doctor so that he can see through it and then suggest medicine. So those SOS contacts, and then there is also the facility of contacting family members. So if in somewhere you stay far from your parents and like that, so if it comes to know, instead of letting you know because you'll panic, it will directly contact your family members and tell them so that they can take care of the later situations. So basically here all the components are, most of the components are TI components, and some obviously are other components which we are using. So the main launchpad we are using is the TBAR-C 123 series for the signal processing, and this is the ADS-1292 module. The analog front end via which we will take the ECG signals. You can see the probe is here, and these are the electrodes which take these to the body of the patient. And finally, this reading, it has its own software. So, this ECG reading will directly come into the software. So, then we use a Bluetooth module which will transfer this signal to the app, and from app, we will send it to cloud, and then the processing will be done there. And the later part, like the result, will come back to the app and you can see what is happening and then you can contact. And additionally, it also has a fall detection technology. Like if at some time this person falls or like he is not in his senses, so this thing will alert and send a message to the relatives and friends that okay, this person is not responding now. So right now we are progressing, and this is what we have done till now. Okay, later we can show you the demonstration on this application.
Yeah. Only one thing to add, this thing, yeah, excellent thing, Peter. Only one thing, that generally the critical heart attack appears generally before 1 week or 2-3 days prior to it, they are giving signals. And generally, and that is, yes, that is some sort of invariable signals. So it is basically a continuous ECG type of thing. So that, yeah.
It's a wearable device. Yeah. Like if I could show you the setup, we don't have it here. It's a wearable. It's a chest belt like this, and the device stays here, and the ECG electrode can directly connect it to the body. I can show you.
So this is the person first, yes.
Do you have any check whether these are taking proper data or not?
That is what we have to validate now. Right? Yeah. That is what we are working on right now. We are getting the signal, but actually last time we had a problem is that the placements, we don't know the placements correctly. Like we are not doctors or nurses, so ECG is placed at this position, so it gives the correct reading. So probably we were placing the electrode in such a position that it was not giving the exact reading. So those are the things we need to check right now.
Yeah, there we can suggest secondly our doctor will help us. Avantika, we are in medical team, our doctor will hear us. So this this thing is better. He's a doctor. He's our campus comes on the Saturdays.
Another thing that is, this is not very preliminary level work, but whatever, as it's part of your work, as you are transferring the data via Bluetooth. Okay, so the data is taken from a form of patient one. Okay, now you are transferring the data. Then the cloud,
louder, please.
And where the data processing is done, and after that all the diagnosis is done. Okay, make sure that this data is for patient 1, because when multiple patients are
giving the data. That security has to be there. And
sometimes it may happen, the data may overlap, or it may happen that patient one is being treated with patient two's data.
Yes, yeah, that is a, and one more thing, that is, these are very private information, like someone's health information. So the security is a very important thing here. We cannot show anyone else the information of one person. That is a very big risk factor. You cannot take that.
That is fine. That is also a rule of health, of private data, of health data. That is fine. But if patient one is treated with patient two's data, it is very dangerous.
Yes. So we actually, if we show you the app, there is a direct login page that you have to log in with your username and password, and then only you can operate. Whatever will come there, it's yours, not someone else's.
No, yes, it's fine.
Here I want to say something.
I don't know about the ECG. I think it's the others, like MRI. MRI, it cannot be, because MRI data, it is stored in a DICOM file. And DICOM file always patient name, date, which patient are built into the file itself. The giving the file, it is like OSIL 7 layer structure. So not only your image data, patient, doctor, his age, machine name, everything is there. I don't know the ECG data, can you put in a DICOM file? This whole data can be, then this swapping cannot be done. Because every of that information should be there.
Swapping over letting
this time.
So each and every one, they won't be able to afford it. So what, as our distribution channels, we have taken to NGOs or to panchayat, gram panchayats, like they will keep a set of these instruments with them, and when in the village someone needs it, so they go and assist that person with a device.
In that case, communication became more complicated, because the same instrument, suppose you have four people have paid for this cardio data, and maybe you have made this is using this device as a time slotting way. So how four patients are attached with that adapter? Now for initial 5 minutes your data is taken, next 5 minutes next one's data is taken, next 5 minutes patient's data is taken, and next 5 minutes if this kind of approach can be done over here, then the authentication becomes more complicated. Because that time, a person specific biometric authentication should be done with the data taken prior to the data taken.
Okay.
That's
a
very
point.
Valid point.
Now, then another question you have to answer, a little one. This is right now we want to make it in an open source of hardware. Our software is open source because we have developed everything on open source. We are not tied down to any big company like Microsoft or this thing, open source. The hardware, can you make it open hardware? Open hardware means like Arduino, Raspberry Pi, which is not in a particular company because they are open technologies. Can it be done?
It can be done.
Same side. That is the reason you should start thinking. Because your software layer should be same. Your software should be same. It should can work with our TI product and non-TI product. Say, if the TI product is successful, good enough. But if this route somehow is blocked, then you should carry on this thing. It's lot of hard work you have done, and promise have done. So you should continue with open system. Because it is totally design ideas is yours. It is no way, but we are using TI, but you should quickly start the non-TI use. And the software should be the same. Software should be the same, whether it's a TI or not. So that's the device driver level. That should be the only difference. And I think the cost will be much lower. Any idea how much will be the cost if you do
it? It will be lower, because in TI, each component, it costs a lot. It's very costly.
Very costly, very difficult to get.
I have to ship everything from US and then the delivery charge itself is greater than the amount I have to pay for the device.
So we cannot. So immediately you should start with the because the idea is ours, yours. So you should immediately start from, if not today, from tomorrow, non-care services to start. Because we cannot, because our college will not give fund much. They are funded, but how much fund I don't know. But now, non-TI, we can fund. Our teachers can fund. I can fund. Sam can fund. We don't have to depend on
data validation.
Data
validation. That whether there is at all attached or it is loses.
Yes.
Why you lose it?
What madam has said? What madam has said that by this week, please Ravandika, remember the doctor, at least local doctor, you must know all of us. Sam is connected with the project, I was connected with you and your other members. Should know how to detail the positions and fix this growth. Okay. This is very important. So you should learn this. These are, now you cannot say you don't know, I don't know. You have to be expert. Whatever you do,
I
yes, I have checked it yesterday.
But you need
a
doctor will help us.
Doctor can show.
You know, they see it here. I see when they come to ECG, they love it. They actually are looking for some pain. They put it on some pain. Okay, next thing. You want to focus something? You can focus the hardest for the. Because I need a boy. Can you help me, boy?
It's after double C. Ball, both of them, everybody can check the both of them. Left, right, it is nice. Okay.
But we don't
just,
have
this.
Okay, just.
No, I mean, it's. Recording of both, details of both.